2019 Aston Martin Vantage. For the first time ever, I'm happy that the English climate is conveying as foreseen. Shakespeare's home province of Warwickshire is secured with a chill grayness, what his Bardness once portrayed as infertile winter, with his furious nipping cool, and the streets are moist and oily. This is the ideal area to answer a portion of the more huge inquiries we have about the new Aston Martin Vantage in front of its formal dispatch in the not-so-distant future. As you'd anticipate from James Bond's occasionally most loved auto organization, the procedures are extremely shroud and knife. In spite of the fact that we've just observed what the completed Vantage looks like and experienced it from the traveler situate in solidified Sweden, our first drive isn't a model that wears an intentionally monstrous yellow and dark camouflage and conveys no Aston Martin marking, in spite of the fact that it has the logo of tire provider Pirelli writ expansive on its entryways. I'm additionally joined by Matt Becker, Aston's central vehicle qualities design and a man who find out about tuning sports autos than for all intents and purposes any other individual on the planet. His past gig was as Lotus taking care of supervisor. This unquestionably isn't the trial of anything besides the driving knowledge. Outside styling is adequately covered up by the hallucinogenic zebra wrap, and the inside bears the scars of an existence lived hard. Advancement designs regularly appear to respect testing the toughness of trim and fittings as a feature of the activity. Contrasted with the greater DB11, the seating position feels lower, and despite the fact that there is a decent scope of modification, being situated nearer to the windshield implies the fatigue column gobbles up more front quarter perceivability. The two autos share a similar direct and haggle part advanced instrument group, yet the Vantage's switchgear and rigging determination catches our bunched spring down on the middle reassure. Vantage points. From the minute the motor begins, it's unmistakable the Vantage is an alternate mammoth. It shares the DB11's AMG source twin turbo 4.0 liter V8. The DB11 is additionally accessible with a twin turbo V12, however gets a substantially darker soundtrack. Our test auto was breathing out through what will be a discretionary game fumes, however notwithstanding leaving Aston's new Wellsborne designing focus at an aware pace, it sounded both louder and angrier than whatever else fitted with this motor, beside a Mercedes AMG GTR, that is. Becker says the fumes note has been tuned to give more higher frequencies, as they are more qualified to the character of the auto. There are some stunningly noisy pops and blasts while lifting off the throttle, as well. The model's ZF8 speed programmed gearbox will be the main transmission decision at dispatch, in spite of the fact that a 7-speed manual will take after. The transaxle is raise-mounted to help advance the Vantage's weight dissemination, cited as the 50 hours 50 minutes front to raise, however controls the back wheels through a progressed electronically controlled constrained slip differential, something the DB11 doesn't get in either 8 or 12 chamber shape. A more energetic drive. Indeed, even at low speeds the Vantage feels obviously unique in relation to the DB11. While the controlling rack and proportion are indistinguishable, the Vantage's wheelbase is 4 inches shorter, making the front end detectably more responsive. The suspension feels firmer, as well, the Vantage has punchier frame modes, with the controlling wheel-mounted control cycling among Sport, Sport Plus, and Track, while the DB11 has GT, Sport, and Sport Plus. Becker says the back suspension subframe is inflexibly mounted to the reinforced aluminum body, making a stiffer, yet louder, structure than the DB11's bushing segregated subframe. Game mode still feels acceptably consistent over a portion of the unpleasant cut street surfaces we take toward the Foss Way. And also being one of the most established streets in Europe, initially worked by the Roman Empire to make it less demanding to placate insubordinate Celts and Angles almost 2,000 years prior, the Foss Way is a most loved of the UK's undercarriage engineers on account of its low movement levels, very much located straights, dubious cambers, and regularly medieval surfaces. Other than different distance, we see a few masked models from Jaguar Land Rover's adjacent gate and designing base being hustled along. It's nothing unexpected that the Vantage is brisk. The AMG V8 has abundant wicked good torque, however like numerous a genuine pure breed, it's most joyful while being wrapped by the whip, pulling progressively firmly as it surrounds the 7,000 revolution per minute red line. As we noted with the DB11 V8, the marriage between the motor and the ZF Auto, which AMG doesn't use in its own models, is an especially upbeat one, conveying shifts that vibe subjectively as speedy as those of a double grass programmed into powertrain's more forceful modes. Becker concedes that in-track mode upshifts are really impeded partially finished Sport Plus to give a greater torque knock and a louder fume split. The 295/35R20 raised tires find copious hold in the tricky conditions, and the skeleton disregards surface flaws. Up until this point, so Aston, yet turning onto littler and more tightly streets uncovers what the Vantage is decent at. The front end remains reliable and informative as speed increments, and now the diff at the back likewise gets an opportunity to indicate how cunning it is. Becker says that it can deliver up to 1,845 pounds to foot of locking power in a split second, substantially more than a regular mechanical constrained slip differential. This serves to both boost hold and to vector torque over the back pivot. The outcome is remarkable footing in the oily conditions yet without the low speed understeer that forceful LSTs frequently incite. It feels deft and secure yet traditionally throttle steerable to a great degree, even with the solidness control exchanged completely on, and it's raucous without being alarming with it turned off. All things considered, the new Vantage is an auto fit for doing apparently opposing things. That the manual gearbox rendition will have a less progressed mechanical differential is probably going to confine its allure considerably more distant than the preference that purchasers appear to have against autos with grasp pedals. Different impressions are fundamentally transient. In evaluation terms, this is a some tea as opposed to a full English breakfast. The Vantage's brake pedal has a pleasant firm weight, however little travel, impediment being down to weight instead of development. Becker says that the Porsche 911 GT3 was the motivation for the pedal feel. The seats feel great following hour in the driver's seat, in spite of the fact that the cockpit is beginning to feel tight as opposed to comfortable when we return to Wellsbourne. Be that as it may, in general, the signs are great to be sure.